Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to Book Island. This is Juhi and here I post booky stuffs. Today's topic is defamiliarization. So without further ado, let me begin. The emergence of postmodernism in critical theory was a result of a shift in approaching a work of literature with the beginning of 20th century. In the opening decades of 20th century, Russian formalism emerged as a spontaneous reaction to the mystification of literature traced in the art movement of symbolism. On one hand, symbolism took literature as a tool to bring out a universal truth that can be unveiled through looking sideways critically at the world to see the ideal Platonic form that creates all. Russian formalists thought literature could be analyzed by concentrating on language and engaging formal literary devices on the other hand. So Russian formalists were way more concerned with the literariness than the notion of literature. Exactly this is the key concern of Slavsky recorded in his essay Art as Technique, where it claims that literariness is an upshot of a specific use of language. In simpler words, it is actually defamiliarized everyday language that interrupts our habituated automatic perception of words. The interruption of a result forces the reader to make additional effort to understand the meaning of the text, what in turn enlivens the wonders of the world. In Slavsky's words, habitualization devours words. Art exists that one may recover the sensation of life. It exists to make one feel things, to make the stone stony. Slavsky, 1925. In accordance with Slavsky, the primary concern of the writer is to furnish an unusual, unaccustomed, unfamiliar world so the reader can experience it afresh. If we take this example, the writer's job is to provide the experience of the artful nature of the stone rather than naturally regard stone as an object. Slavsky further adds in his essay that art has no particular purpose in itself and only historical and psychological context should not be the primary concerns of a writer, because the ultimate aim of art is to make objects unfamiliar, to make forms difficult to perceive. It should be, as he states, like the sensation of holding a pen for the first time for a child. But contemporary critics did not accept this strange definition of art recorded in the essay Art as Technique, which is, the purpose of art is to impart the sensation of things as they are perceived and not as they are known. The technique of art is to make objects unfamiliar, to make forms difficult, to increase the difficulty and length of perception, because the process of perception is an aesthetic end in itself and must be prolonged. Art is a way of experiencing the artfulness of an object. The object is not important. Slavsky, 1925. Many critics turned down this theory based on the view that no literary work is free of external elements. For example, New Marxists believe mutual correlation between infrastructure where society belongs and superstructure where a work of art exists. Others like Gunn supported the theory, stating, art restores experience to us by distorting and showing down the perception by making the world strange once again. Gunn, 1984, he explains that that in formalist criticism, the content is created by recreated disordering the form and keeping aside all the accepted norms to reveal the unseen doors of literature before readers who struggling through the text now will be forced to look again to see like almost for the very first time. Gunn explains the habituated and autonomized use of literature makes literature familiar to both the reader and writer. As he states, our habitual perception is caused not by direct experience of the object but by a comfortable familiar way of writing about it. Gunn said it in 1984. I am going to talk more about this matter, but before moving forward, I want to tell you guys, YouTube tells 85% of you people enjoy my content but haven't subscribed yet. If you enjoy my content, please do subscribe because it really really encourages me to create fresh new content. Now, back to the topic that we are discussing today. To see the literature as it is, the familiarity must be broken. So, defamiliarization comes to aid here. As Derrida suggests, deconstructed to attain its artistic aims. Slavsky clearly writes, a work of art is perceived against a background of and by means of association with other works of art. A new form appears not in order to express a new content but in order to replace an old form which has already lost its artistic value. Slavsky said this in 1925. So the simplest definition of defamiliarization would be the artistic technique by which an author can portray common things in a very strange, unfamiliar way to arouse the natural perspective in a reader to enhance familiar things so that the world can be experienced anew. For example, Holzhammer by Tolstoy is a fine instance of defamiliarization, where unfamiliar narrator is a horse. In same too, Tolstoy utilized defamiliarization to show fogging in a shocking way. According to Selden, formalists were more focused on defamiliarization of literature rather than capturing reality. He adds that the mechanism of literature had been shifted from social values and familiar fixed definitions. So the formalists took literature as an open space, always bare to changes and fresh definitions. This perspective later emerged as postmodernism, where component of languages losing their meanings will stop responding to their referent. Then Slavsky's idea was to shatter the illusion of real through laying bare the literature what Brecht later adopted in his alienation effect. By laying bare, he meant literature independent of any social values and conventionalized reality used by writers as eccentric excuse to defend their employment of formal devices. In Selden's words, we refuse to allow a text to remain alien and outside our frames of references. We insist on naturalizing it and effacing its textuality. So, defamiliarization encounters naturalizing of literature rather than naturalness or reality. Thus, defamiliarization, along with its drawbacks, provided people the opportunity to perceive the world from a different perspective. As post-World War world started to neglect the fact that our basic beliefs, presuppositions can be shattered, an absolute definition of reality without reality was established. To shift the attitude towards literature from partial to fair, concepts must be deconstructed again and again so the possibility of meaning according to historical and social consciousness flows freely. So here we end today. That's all for today. If you have enjoyed this video, please like, share and subscribe to stay connected. I shall be meeting you with another bookish video. Till then, bye bye. Abar dekha hobe.